Hey, this is Eric from Native Instruments, and in this video we are going to take a closer look at the re-edit functions of TRAKTOR DJ 2. Let's start with looping. Looping allows you to choose a portion of a track and play it indefinitely. You can turn a loop on or off by either pressing this loop button here, where the number shows you the length of the loop, so this is set to 4 beats right now, or by directly tapping 2 fingers into the waveform. The further your fingers are apart, the bigger the loop will be, all the way from 32 beats down to 1/32nd of a beat. Once the loop is set, you can use this green handle to move it within the track or change its size with the arrows down here. The next thing we will take a look at is hotcues. Hotcues are like bookmarks within your track to which you can jump to whenever you want. To access them on the iPad, tap this hotcue button. We can set one here at the start of a track with the kick drum. Here's a clap, so we can set one here. And here's a bit with a vocal that I like. And here's a break I might want to jump to. Hotcues will always snap to a beat, so when you use them, you'll stay in sync. I can also set a loop and save it as a hotcue. If I want to delete a hotcue, I just hit delete and tap the hotcue I want to delete. Next, let's quickly look at freeze mode. This works in both layouts, but in waveform layout we have a bit more space to play around. Hit the little snowflake at the bottom left and the waveform will stop moving, while the track keeps on playing in the background. Each segment here behaves like a hotcue, so I quickly jump around between different parts. If sync is on, your chops will always be on beat, but you can also turn it off to go wild. With a bit of practice, you can start really juggling things up. If you want to learn more about TRAKTOR DJ 2, just look at the other videos in this playlist and hit subscribe.